Today we're going to be talking about three kitchen mindset makeovers. So why do you need a kitchen mindset makeover? Well, it's really important that you start to feel comfortable in the kitchen. Not because you're going to spend hours there, but that is really where the healthy eating will come into place. So we hear the same sayings, I guess, from our clients all the time. And we're going to cover those and then give you a little swap out, so, or reframe those possible negative kitchen phrases.
So our first phrase of the day is, I'm a bad cook. So we hear so many clients have this feeling that they can't cook healthy meals because they're not a good cook. We just want to say that we are not fancy cooks at all. And that you don't need to be Julia Child or do any gourmet cooking or follow those fancy cooking shows. You can get into the kitchen and do extremely simple, easy meals that can taste great. And we have a lot of recipes that we share on our website that use very minimal ingredients that are really delicious, because we know that many people don't want to spend a lot of time in the kitchen. But you don't want to feel like you're a bad cook to be an obstacle, because you want to turn that mindset around and say to yourself, oh, I'm learning how to be a better cook. I can get in the kitchen. I can make a simple dish and have it come out healthy. Like, just kind of look at that through a different lens.
For sure. So let's talk about mindset number two. And this is probably the most common one, wouldn't you say? But it's that cooking takes too much time. I don't have time to cook. So that is really our specialty. So we don't have any more time in our day than you do. And we are always looking for shortcuts. We have a bunch, as Jane was talking about, we have recipes and ideas in our on our blog. But there are so many options out there today. And there's healthy fast food. It doesn't have to be the drive-through fast food, but we actually, of course, we created a brand out for you of brands that you can keep in your freezer that are really quick and easy, but they're still healthy. We're all for shortcuts, for sure, as long as they're healthy. Just buying some cut up vegetables at the store, that's going to save you so much time, but it also kind of takes away that excuse of not having enough time.
Absolutely.
So let's reframe that, I don't have enough time, and say, I am finding healthy alternatives that don't take too much time.
Perfect.
Yeah?
Yeah, that's a good one.
Let's go to number three. The kitchen is dangerous. And we do, there's sharp knives and all these scary tools and things in there. Well, that's not really what we mean by dangerous. A lot of times clients will tell us that they're afraid to go into the kitchen because that's just where they'll kind of fall down the rabbit hole. There's so many things that they want to eat. And, well, okay, there's two ways that you can fix that up. And one is, don't have those things in your kitchen in the first place. And the other is to kind of reframe that mindset and think of your kitchen not as a place of danger and cravings and rabbit holes, and think of it more as a place of healing and creativity.
We like to think of your kitchen as a place of nourishment. So instead of being fearful of it, a place that you can go in and feel comfortable. In fact, we often will play music in our kitchens, right?
Make it fun.
And make it fun, so that it's not a place that you feel it's a chore to be in, or that it's a scary, dangerous place that you're going to just overeat.
So that's our three mindset tips. Let us know what you think in the comments below, and make sure you download our brand out. The link is below.
To show you these.
Yeah.